I'm sorry, I'm a deaf singer. What did you say?
You're so beautiful, all of me.
Oh, she said I'm so beautiful. No.
She said all of us.
She said all of us. Come on. Don't be dreaming. That was totally nuts. Thank you, darling. Really appreciate it. Do you know, seriously, how hard it is to come in a band where we have been together for 17 years, 18 years, I can't count, I've got gray hair now. But regardless, you know, we have our way of looking at each other, we understand each other without words, and all of a sudden comes somebody into our own bedroom kind of thing, right? Sorry, that sounds like a college joke, actually. But it is extremely difficult to say yes to something which is so daring and difficult. So if we could put, please, our hands together for a special guest, Mr. Stephen LaBrie, who came to
to be here tonight to celebrate the life of Carlos Marin. Such an incredible artist with such a unique voice. And it is a privilege to share the stage here with Il Divo.
We are very, very happy that you're here with us tonight. By the way, I've known Stephen for quite some time at this point, going on about 10 years, and we've performed together and known each other in our personal lives, and I can say he's just such an incredible artist, and he really has been making his name singing operas in major houses all around the world.
Yeah, but there's one thing I don't like about him.
What's that?
He's very young.
Well, actually, think about it. He's exactly the same age we were when we started with Il Divo 17 years ago.
Oh, God, so you're even younger than what I thought, right?
Well, anyways, jokes aside, thank you very much for being here with us tonight, Stephen.
Thank you.
You got some fans, baby. Well, when David Wurst and I, we decided to put this show together, apart from choosing the songs, we believed it was so important to remember Carlos not only through his music, but also through all the wonderful memories he left us. So I'm going to start with a little story. Please don't fall asleep, because I'm French and I can't take 30 minutes. But I live in California since 10 years, so I'll make it 15. So I don't know if many of you know, but the reason I'm part of this wonderful band Il Divo is because of Carlos Marin. Back in 2003, I was in Paris, and I was asked to write some songs as a songwriter for a musical. And at that time, I had the chance to meet Carlos's partner back then. Her name is Geraldine. She told me that they were looking for somebody who could sing some sort of pop in a crossover band. And I said, wow, that sounds amazing. I'm totally up for it. I'd love that. So it's only after a few hours that I get a phone call. And I hear, hello, baby. Maybe let's take the baby off, but that was for the girls. It's Carlos. I heard that you have a good voice, right? And we started literally already laughing because I was playing piano really badly, and he's asked me to sing some stuff. We connected instantly. And after the phone call, only a few days after that, I got a call from the record label who were then involved, and they had set up an audition in Paris at the Opera Bastille, where I had the chance to meet for the very first time Mr. David Mellor. Right there. The wonderful David. But guess what? He had like long hair and then earrings, but like ornaments type things. And cowboy boots. Yeehaw! And I was like, is this really like a crossover audition? Anyways, it was really funny. What are you going like?
I don't know, it's not about me.
It's not about you. Anyways, it's only after a week that actually all four of us, we got to London and thrown straight into a recording studio. And then the rest is history because, in fact, you've created the magic for us. We became then successful and had the chance to travel the world with a wonderful man, Carlos. But I have to say that I am extremely thankful, Carlos, for everything you've done for me, because without you, I would never be in this band. You really raised me up. Thank you so much, man. We really miss you.